DJ Tambi is a world-class tattoo artist working out of Bad Apple Tattoos in Las Vegas, but he is also a husband, father, a digital artist, and a painter. Tattooing for more than 20 years, DJ got his start in Rochester, New York, before hitting the scene in Las Vegas, where he has remained ever since. To see DJ draw some iconic characters, including Beetlejuice, the Grinch, and even Santa Claus, there are videos on DJ's YouTube channel, which I have linked in the description. Unfortunately, there are only 8 videos, with the last ones uploaded more than a year ago, but I do recommend them if you are interested in watching a master work. On April 3rd, 2013, Season 2 of Best Ink premiered on the Oxygen Network. This reality show contest featured 12 tattoo artists vying for $100,000 and the cover of a tattoo magazine. Sounds kind of familiar. One of the 12 artists was DJ Tambi, who did well in the competition, but ultimately finished in second place behind the winner, Teresa Sharp. Meanwhile, Spike TV had their own tattoo reality television show called Ink Master. And on June 6th of 2017, Season 9 began. This season was to feature 18 tattoo shops from around the country in a competition to be crowned Spike TV's Master Shop. Each shop sent 2 artists, with Old Town Ink out of Scottsdale, Arizona, being represented by DJ Tambi and Season 4 contestant Aaron Bubba Irwin. When DJ walked in, you could tell by the reactions of the other contestants that he was already well known, as they did not seem happy to be competing against him. In hindsight, this feeling was obviously justified, as Old Town Ink would go on to win the season. I went to oldtowninc.com, where I learned that Bubba Irwin still works there, alongside Tommy Helm, another former Ink Master contestant. But according to DJ's bio, he has always tattooed out of Las Vegas, so perhaps his time at Old Town was brief. Or maybe it was all just a reality TV untruth. Leave a comment if you can shed any light on the subject. January of 2018 saw Ink Master Season 10 premiering on Spike TV. This season was called Return of the Masters, and featured 3 teams led by previous winners Steve Teft, Anthony Michaels, and DJ Tambi. The season was ultimately won by Joshua Payne, who was on DJ's team, so an unofficial win for DJ. But the season finale also had the 3 coaches competing head-to-head-to-head in a master face-off, which DJ won, netting him a $100,000 prize. On November 12th of 2019, Ink Master Grudge Match premiered on the Paramount Network. This show sought to bring to a close several tattoo artists' grudges, hence the name, and featured 3 former winners as judges. The 3 being Ryan Ashley Malarkey, Clean Rock One, and DJ Tambi. This is not to be confused with the previous year's Ink Master Season 11, which was also called Grudge Match and also featured Clean Rock One. It truly was a confusing time to be a fan of tattoo competition reality television shows. So a shop represented by DJ had won Ink Master, as had a team led by him, and he had even beaten Steve and Anthony in the Master Face-Off. But when the show was canceled in 2020 due to COVID and some racist pictures, it seemed that DJ would never have the chance to just outright win an Ink Master season. A sad ending indeed. But wait. During the summer of 2022, it was announced that Ink Master would be returning for a 14th season, this time on streaming network Paramount Plus. When the show premiered in September, it showcased a new host, 3 new judges, and several prior contestants, as well as a $250,000 prize, the highest so far. Then, on episode 4, 4 winners from previous seasons also joined the competition. These being DJ Tambi, Tony Medellin, Anthony Michaels, and Steve Teft. Spoiler alert, DJ is the first ever 3-time Ink Master winner. And this was no pushover season. but perhaps one of the fiercest Ink Master competitions yet. To book a tattoo from DJ, send an email to djtambi@gmail.com and be sure to check out his Instagram at djtambi, as that is where I found all of these tattoos. If you enjoyed this peek into DJ's portfolio, consider subscribing to my channel for more tattoo content. And since you stayed until the end, maybe leave a comment telling me why you stuck around. I really hope you're not stalking me. Either way, thanks for watching. And until next time, goodbye and good luck.